Fiber is one of the most important things for your health. The number one cause for death in America is heart disease. And the number one cause for that is animal products, because they're really high in saturated fat, cholesterol, hormones, estrogen, IGF-1, methionine, choline, which leads to cancer. You need to help get that stuff out of your body. Plus, animal products have zero fiber. They stay in your system a long time. And when stuff stays in your colon for a long time, that's one of the big causes for colon disease and cancer and things like that. 97% of America doesn't even get its minimum daily requirement of fiber. Refined bread, pasta, cereal, pancakes, cookies, milk, orange juice, it's almost no fiber. It's low fiber. It's considered low fiber. Even if you vegetables, if you overcook, if you cook them to death, you're changing it. It's not a good fiber anymore. Cooked vegetables are considered a low fiber diet. What the body needs is raw plant matter, raw plant vegetables. That's what feeds the probiotics. That's what a prebiotic is. This is a prebiotic fiber. Prebiotics are what feeds probiotics. Probiotics are the 5 pounds of gut flora you have in you. That's your army. The trillions of little microbacteria that fight for you, that break down the estrogens and the metals and makes things more absorbable into your system and helps your whole digestive process. Probiotics are 2/3 of your immune system. And most people don't have enough probiotics. Why? Because they're eating sugar and bread and things like that to feed the yeast, which overpower the probiotics. And also, they're not getting enough fiber in their diet. And like I said, most of the foods that we eat in the modern world are low fiber or no fiber. All animal products contain no fiber at all. And they have a lot of cholesterol, which is from stress in animal products. And so, fiber is what helps get rid of the cholesterol in your body. It helps get rid of the estrogens, the xenoestrogens. It helps break down the heavy metals and the toxins in your body. It helps not only break it down, but it helps get stuff out of your body so it doesn't get reabsorbed and re-poison you. It is so critical that you have this, because heart disease is the leading cause of death. And it's so simple that taking some fiber can help prevent that. It also helps prevent estrogen-driven cancers like uterine, ovarian, breast cancer, prostate cancer. Fiber, something as simple as fiber. Now, yes, you can eat apples, ground flax seeds, chia, things like that, and you should. But most of you don't have the time, you're in a hurry, you just want to chug something down, you know. So a spoonful of this, just add it to your diet just to be safe. You need your fiber, you need it. And you need the prebiotic fiber that feeds the probiotics. If there's something that's going to motivate you even more than health issues, probiotics and fiber help you lose weight. They help you stay thin. It helps rid your body of the bad stuff and helps get it out of you so it doesn't reabsorb. So if you want to stay thin and good looking, and they've found, tests have shown that thin people have 70% more gut flora than overweight people, which basically overweight people just have yeast. They just have an overabundance of candida. And what kills probiotics? Antibiotics. Antibiotics kill probiotics. Prebiotics feed probiotics. So if you've had a lot of antibiotics in your life, you need to take this. By the way, you can't just go to the store and buy some probiotics. Why? Because they're living things. They're little microorganisms in a capsule. A, they've been sitting on a shelf in a store for probably half a year. They're probably dead. B, they have to go into your stomach acid, which kills living things. So it's acid. You're putting living things in acid. Most of them are not going to make it down to your gut. So really, the thing to do is to feed the ones that are down there. This is like sending relief supplies to a few soldiers stranded behind enemy lines and making them stronger again. That's what the probiotic fiber does. You need to feed the ones that are already down there. There are 10,000 strains of gut bacteria. The stuff you buy in a store, there's about 7 strains. And most of those are like lactobacillus, acidophilus, bifidus, which are mainly designed to digest lactose, which is milk. You know, people don't even do milk anymore. It's not gonna do you much good. You need the other 10,000 variety of bacteria, which you're never gonna be able to buy in the store. So you're gonna have a few of them left. There's always survivors. Even if you've had a bunch of antibiotics, there's probably a few of them left of all the 10,000 strains. So you need to just feed them and make them stronger again. So it's really important that you beef up the ones that are already down there by sending them their food that they like, which is this. And by the way, if you haven't had a lot of antibiotics in your life, but you eat meat or milk or cheese or yogurt or any kind of animal product, you're getting antibiotics. and you're killing your gut flora. And if you're wondering why you have digestive issues, why you're bloating a lot, why you have problems, it's because that's what they give the animals so they don't get sick in those factory farms. They give them antibiotics. So even if you're doing milk and cheese, you know, Caesar salad, creamy dressings, creamy soups, you're getting antibiotics. Even if you don't eat meat, even fish, eggs, all that stuff has antibiotics in it. And you're accumulating it more and more. It builds up in your system. Fiber is what helps get that stuff out of you, but mostly you don't have enough fiber and you don't have enough gut flora. So you got to change that if you really want to be healthy. That's why this is important. This is one of the simplest, easiest, best ways to claim your health back is to get some fiber. Be aware of certain products out there from other companies that claim to be in your best interest, but they have their main ingredient is FOS, fructooleosaccharides. It is a prebiotic, but it's a sugar. It's an isolated sugar, and it feeds candida. So if you have a product that has FOS in it, fructooleosaccharides, beware, because it feeds, and those of you who are taking it, you know what I'm talking about. It makes you bloat, gives you gas, makes you just not feel too great, and cause a lot of stomach digestive problems too. The reason they use it is because it tastes like sugar. It's sweet. And that's why they use it, because they know you're going to get hooked on it. You're going to love it. You go, I love this product. It tastes great. And they tell me it's good for me. Well, yeah, because it's sugar. It's an isolated sugar. So yeah, it does feed the probiotics, but it also feeds the candida. My products are just ground up plants. That's all it is. I mean, it's the whole thing, the way nature intended. You need prebiotic fiber, but you got to get the right kind. It's not a big investment. Just take a spoonful every day and watch what happens. Especially the next morning when you wake up and you look in the mirror and you see your chiseled body starting to come out. You'll go, thank you, Markus. Thank you so much. Anyway, get your fiber. All right, just somehow get your fiber every day.